I'm Rick Hanson, and I'd like to welcome you to these Wednesday meditations, which are, for me personally, they feel like a kind of safe harbor, or to draw on a theme that we've been exploring for the past couple months. They're a kind of refuge, a sanctuary, a pit stop, a refueling station, particularly in terms of the opportunity to gather together with like-minded people. We practice with others, we practice for others, we practice alongside others. And so I'm really happy to be with you. You're welcome to turn on your camera if you want. You're welcome to leave it off. If you want to communicate during my talk with other people or with me, you're welcome to use the chat sidebar. You're also welcome to push the chat button at the bottom of your screen again to make that sidebar go away, if you don't want to see all that. Our practice, our schedule, as you may know, is to begin with meditation in a minute or so, till 35 minutes past the hour. Then we'll take a 10-minute break and begin at a quarter to the hour, a quarter to 7 p.m. in Pacific time, where I am in California, and then go till 7:30, half past 7 Pacific time, at which point those who want can leave. And if you're still here after a few minutes have passed, then my co-host and co-pilot here, Tom Brown, with the psychedelic paintings behind him, will sort you into Zoom-based breakout rooms, which are entirely optional, of roughly four or so people each. Okay? So my theme tonight is, I've been working with the refuge of acceptance, accepting your experiences, accepting yourself altogether, accepting other people, and last now, we're going to explore accepting the world. In this meditation, I'm going to invite you into a certain kind of mindfulness that, for me at least, is very supportive of finding that sweet spot in which we can release the suffering of fighting with the way it is, while at the same time preserving a heartfeltness and a courage to do what we can to help things become better. So let's meditate. Finding a posture that supports you in being comfortable and relaxed. It can help to have a sense of erectness, but not uptightness. A sense of carefree dignity, to use a wonderful title from Sokni Rinpoche's book. Carefree dignity. I like the combination of that. Eyes open or closed. Letting yourself come to a sense of ease. Being aware of your body, or being aware of whatever is okay to be aware of in your body. Perhaps the feeling of your feet on the floor. Your breathing. The bodily sense of being. Being present in the present. allowing sounds, thoughts, feelings, whatever, to come and go while you remain present and aware. If it's comfortable for you, being aware of sensations in the center of your chest, near your heart, as you breathe. And exploring and including different aspects of heartfeltness, such as open-heartedness, courage, compassion, or even experiences that don't have a good word for them, but we know what they feel like. So I'll be quiet for some moments as you just take heartfeltness in different qualities or nuances as your object of attention in this meditation, which may well include a sense of the sensations in the area of your heart. In a broad sense, what's it like to be in your heart while you abide in the present? you might have a sense of heartfeltness, one quality or another, warmth, compassion, tenderness, sort of flavoring your own consciousness. And then, while remaining rested, primarily in a sense of ease and open-heartedness, if you like, bring to mind something that you find mildly unpleasant. You don't like it. You wish it were different. Maybe in what you're experiencing right now, maybe in your home setting or the world around you, and see what it's like to be rested in heartfeltness while being aware of this thing you don't like. And see if it's possible for resting in heartfeltness to help you accept the reality of the thing you don't like, while potentially also making space for you to have plans about what you're going to do about it, but without carrying the extra load of resistance or anger or aversion to what you don't like. All that might sound complicated, keeping it simple. In a meditative space, resting in the heart, aware of something you find unpleasant, unwanted, you don't want it, and seeing what it's like to be aware of both, the sense of heartfeltness and the thing you don't like, and see if this combination is helpful to you. And you can try this with multiple things, even potentially with things that you pretty intensely don't like. And if you get lost in this, if it seems too complicated, just come back to the sensations around the physical heart in your chest, and a sense of easeful meditation. If you get it all lost, recenter in the heart. Sensations in your chest and associated feelings of openness, warmth, of courage. And you can explore how being centered in the heart helps us with the things we don't want, conditions we don't like. And you can explore how being centered in your heart helps you feel more accepting of things you don't like, including ones that just won't change, can't change. Resting in the heart helps us be more at peace with them. And in the last 5 minutes, simply rest in the heart, breathing, abiding, with an open, warm heart. In the last minute, you might like to open your eyes while continuing to meditate.